this week. I have been mostly prepping ammonites.
So the sea's already done a lot of the hard work for us here. It's taken a lot of the matrix off. I'll go on this side so we can reveal a bit more here. Looks quite pyritized, so it's going to be another hard one. That other one was bullet hard limestone and pyrite. So I'm just going to get the engraver and just thin out this matrix a little more first before we try popping it off. With the engraver, I'm working towards the middle of the ammonite, taking away the matrix towards the center, so we're keeping away from the ribs, removing as much matrix as we can before we actually start to reveal the ammonite's ribs. Let the tool do the work, and when you feel you're getting close to the ammonite, hold back and just wait for the pop. Try not to push or you'll end up damaging the ammonite. Now I'm starting to carefully thin down the matrix so we can reveal the next set of whorls. This is a very, very sticky pyritic matrix. It's not popping very nicely. So I'm going to try and get this matrix as thin as possible before popping. You can see now some of the center spiral whorls starting to come out. Coming away slowly. Very, very sticky. Take your time, let the tool do the work. Try not to push too hard. Great tool for beginners, the electric engraver. And if you're lucky enough, you've bought the Dremel 290. But you gotta make sure you got these tungsten tips from Zoic PalaeoTech. They turn into a completely different animal. I only have two of the tips, you can get three. I've got the matrix remover and the flat chisel. You can get one for more fine detail, which probably I could do with here. You've probably noticed I use two machines. They get very hot after a time and they're extremely noisy, so you gotta make sure you've got some decent ear defenders. This is where now you really have got to start being gentle and waiting for the pop. But this sticky, sticky, horrible pyrite matrix is proving difficult. We'll get a little bit of takeaway, so just keep going gentle. And, just wait and hope for that pop. This is why I only use beach-worn ammonites, ones that aren't of any significant value. If you've got a good ammonite, save it to be professionally prepped. But seaworn beauties like this, they're great for practice. You can always have another practice on the other side. You do often find that one side of an ammonite usually fossilises a lot better than the other side. As to be one of my worst preps ever, I do apologise. This is so heavily pyrited, that is so hard to get into, that was the worst I've ever done. Poor old engraver struggled on that. This one's from a previous video. This one I did clean up with a wire brush. Give this one a go, but She's not nice. Not cleaned out much more of that. Very hard, very nasty pyrite. Half of this golden is just where the brass brushes rubbed off onto the pyrite. So now we now know that the limestone is pretty damn hard for. But you can get not too bad a prep. I did one years ago that a friend had given me, and that prep not too bad with the engraver. These ones have been a lot more pyrite-y, especially this one, unfortunately. But you win some, you lose some. See, now if you're giving that to a pro, they would have told you it's not worth prepping, it's pyrite. Or maybe it just needs pro tools. I've just found one I prepped from years ago. So you can achieve quite a reasonable prep with the engraver. I'll give another one a go soon, but I've got to say, new toys are coming, so keep an eye out for the next video. New toys are coming, and if you've managed this long, thank you very much, and please like and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you for all my subscribers and comments and stuff, love it. If there's any other videos you'd like me to do, please let us know. And I'll see you soon for the next video. Thanks for watching.